If you are looking for a sign to join, this is it. What is up, guys, and welcome to my channel. Welcome back if you're a subscriber. If you're not, go ahead and subscribe. I post a little bit of everything. I post travel stuff, I post beauty, hair, clothes, Air Force, you name it, I make the videos. This is gonna be a little two-part video. So this is obviously part one, and I will talk about why I chose to join the Air Force. And then part two will be why I decided to leave the Air Force. So obviously I am no longer in. I got out October, it's now April. That's like 6 months, right? And I know some of you guys might be like, okay, well, if you're no longer in, why are you making a video of why you decided to join? I get quite a few people that DM me on my Instagram and ask me about my military experience, and I posted a day in my life Air Force edition, which I will link below. And from there, I also got a lot of questions and comments, and then also why I'm gonna make part two explaining why I decided to leave the military, just because I feel like it's relevant to know both sides of the story when you're making a decision like that. Most people that come to me with questions are obviously people that are not in yet, and I want them to be like fully informed, like full circle, on my opinions of the military. And again, this is just my experiences and my opinions. So if I say something that you disagree with or whatever, don't drag me in the comments. We could all live in this world having multiple opinions, okay? Now, before I start talking about why I decided to join the military in general, let's go ahead and talk about why the Air Force. So, little background history. My parents are in the Army. They're actually still in. So yeah, so I've basically been a military brat my whole life. So that's a little background history of my life and upbringing. And I decided I was gonna join the military my senior year of high school. Now, why? I'll get into that. Obviously, it plays a part into my why I joined, so we'll get to that eventually. But I decided my senior year that I was gonna join the military. My original choice was gonna be the Army, because to me it just made sense to, because my parents were already in the Army and that's kind of all that I knew. I obviously knew that there were other branches, but I didn't know anything about them. But once I did decide that I wanted to join the military and that I was going to join the Army, I talked to my parents about it, and right as I opened my mouth and said Army, they were like, pump the brakes. They were like, we'll obviously support you with joining the military, whatever branch you want, but we think that you should join the Air Force. And that's the day that I knew my parents really loved me, when they stopped me from joining the Army. Thank you, Mom and Dad. No shade, you know, all the branches are amazing in their own way, but let's just say the Air Force was a better fit for me. So yeah, there was this history. My mind was set on the Air Force. I knew for sure I didn't want to join the Navy because I hated boats, I hated water. And at the time they were still making their females cut their hair into a bob. I felt like that was a little crazy. Like, the military in general was controlling. But I was like, that's a little too much. Like, I would just get in a toxic relationship if I wanted that. And then obviously the Army was out of the window. And then I thought about the Marines, but like very faintly. Like, I didn't really look much into it. But looking back, I wish I joined the Marines, because that's a whole nother beast. But that is really the only branch that I would have really consider joining besides the Air Force. All right, now that we got all of that out the way, let's talk about why I joined the Air Force. So I basically listed down my whys, which ended up being 6, and I labeled them from 1 being the most important and 6 being the least important, but still a big why as to why I joined. Let's just go ahead and start with number one. The number one reason and the main reason that I joined is because going into my senior year, I had absolutely no idea what I wanted to do with my life, like at all. I had no idea where I wanted to go to school, what I wanted to major in, none of that. Like, I never really, I wouldn't say thought about it, but I didn't prep as early as I should have. Like, into my junior year. Like, and on top of that, I didn't really know what I wanted to major in. Like, at the time, I wanted to major in forensic science, and like that was interesting to me, but really it was just because I loved watching CSI, and like that just seemed like such a cool job. But other than that, it's not like I had some deep desire to be a forensic technician. Like, honestly, I didn't know what I wanted to do. The one thing that I did know though is that I did not want to be a broke college student, and I also didn't want to be like struggling, having like 30 part-time jobs while going to school full-time and just being exhausted all the time, and just like the things that you hear from college kids. So my senior year, I was in JROTC. One day a recruiter came in and talked to us, and that's basically where the idea got planted in my head to join the military. I was like, this might not be a bad idea. Like, I feel like it buys me time to figure out what I wanted to do because you're in a contract. And then also, I would be getting paid with no college degree, with no other job experience. I mean, true, it's not like I would be a millionaire and be ballin', but I would have a steady paycheck. And I really just sat there and thought like, okay, somebody is guaranteeing me a paycheck for at least 4 years for that contract while I am thinking of what I really want to do. And if I do 4 years, that will put me at 22, so I'll still be really young. Okay, doesn't sound bad. And that is basically how my train thought went and why I joined. I didn't really think much about it past that. I just knew that it would buy me time to think about something. And then that kind of ties into reason number two, which is money, which I obviously kind of already explained in reason number one. So we'll tie that as reason one and number two. I didn't know what I wanted to do, and money. I honestly had no idea how much I would be making. Like, before I decided to join, like, I didn't look it up beforehand. I just referenced like the life that I had growing up. Like, I was pretty blessed and obviously not super rich, but pretty well off, and I knew that my parents were in the military, so I was like, okay, my life was pretty good and they're in the military, so if I'm in the military, obviously like money's gonna be not a problem. Don't join the military thinking that you're gonna be rich and all that stuff. You're not. But you definitely live like a good, comfortable, like middle class life, and that sounded a lot better than working minimum wage somewhere. And then I also knew that, you know, they paid for your house and they gave you like a monthly stipend for food, and all of that just sounded very attractive. So yeah, that's reason number two. All right, reason number three is independence. I wanted to be out of my house. I always, growing up, was very independent. This is kind of how I was raised. So as soon as I hit 18 and I was graduating, I knew that I wanted to be out the house in a heartbeat. I knew that if I joined the military, I would be stationed somewhere and I would be living on my own, in the dorms at first, and then obviously have my own apartment down the line. So that is reason number three. Moving on to reason number four, I also joined because I knew all of the benefits that would come along with joining. Obviously, like medical, how I said earlier, like paying for my housing, and then all these other benefits that I didn't even know beforehand that, I mean, I know now. And looking back at it now, like the best way that I could describe the military is like living with your parents, but in a very good way. I feel like with the Air Force, like no matter what issue comes up in your life, like they have resources for it, or they have a person who could get that problem fixed, you know what I mean? So I feel like I really didn't have to worry about anything. Now that I'm in the civilian world, I feel like I'm like learning to fully be an adult now, because you don't have anybody holding your hand. Like, you are a free adult, like you're a free civilian, you're a free adult. You figure out where you need to go to get a problem fixed, you do your own research. And I really didn't figure that out until after I joined, but you know, now looking back as an 18-year-old fresh out of high school, like that's very beneficial. And now on the second hand of things, when I say opportunities and benefits, I mean the benefits and opportunities that it would provide as a veteran. I see a lot of employers prioritize hiring veterans. Like, a lot of opportunities are either handed to you or become a lot easier to attain because you're a veteran. Because when I joined, I didn't know exactly if I'll be doing 20 years or just my contract. I knew that afterwards I would kind of have a step forward in a lot of things. And that's really why anybody that comes to me and asks me should they join, I always say yes. Always. Like, there's so many benefits that you could get out of the military by sacrificing 4 years of your life, especially if you're fresh out of high school or young. Like, that 4 years is nothing and they fly by. So it's kind of like you're sacrificing 4 years, but you're getting so much more out of it that it's like worth it. Which leads me to reason number five, and that is school. So I'm pretty sure everybody knows that the military will pay for your school. I think the best thing is that they have tuition assistance to pay for it while you're in, so you don't even have to touch your GI Bill. Like, I have so many friends that have so much student loans, and that alone is persuading enough for me. I'll join again just to know that I don't ever have to have student loans. And now my final reason, reason number six, is because of travel. And growing up, I have lived in Germany, North Carolina, Kentucky, Louisiana. So like, I knew that being in, I would be able to live in all these places that I would have probably never thought of or had a reason to like live in before. So I thought that would be pretty cool and letting me see other places in the world that I hadn't already seen. I didn't travel, I guess, as much as I would have liked to while I was in, but I did have 3 duty stations in those 7 years, so I consider myself pretty lucky, because some people get stuck at bases, you know, for their whole contract and they don't really get to PCS and nothing like that. So I was first stationed in Guam at Anderson Air Force Base. And then after that, I got stationed at Lackland Air Force Base in San Antonio, Texas. And I was stationed there for 2 years and some change. And then afterwards, I finished out the rest of my contract at McGuire Air Force Base in New Jersey. So yeah, guys, that wraps up my 6 reasons why I joined the military. I hope it gives you a little bit more insight. I will say that even though I obviously got out, I don't regret anything. I don't regret joining the military. I don't regret my choices while I was in. I absolutely loved being in. It's one of the best decisions of my life. So if you are thinking of joining, like I said earlier, I tell everybody that thinks that is thinking about it, like, go for it. If you're thinking about it, if you're ready for a lifestyle change, if you want something new, if you're tired of just making minimum wage or just feel like your life isn't going anywhere, it's definitely a good opportunity for you. If you guys have any questions at all, feel free to either comment, email me, or send me a DM on Instagram. I try to get back to absolutely everybody. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it. I'm gonna go ahead and make part 2 now, which is the reasons why I decided to get out of the military. So definitely, if you watch this video, watch that one as well. It'll be the next video that is uploaded after this one in a couple days. I think it's definitely good to get both perspectives. But at the end of the day, I still absolutely recommend joining. Like, if you are looking for a sign to join, this is it. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll catch you guys in my next video.